Veruca Salt is generally regarded as the worst kid from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, no matter which version we're talking about. The most spoiled, competitive, annoying, and just plain awful. She's become the iconic poster child of spoiled children. However, what if she wasn't? What if somehow she was a different person and she didn't care about her money? Simply put, what if Veruca Salt wasn't spoiled? So somehow, Veruca is not a spoiled little brat in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. I know, it's really hard to imagine her as anything else, but let's say hypothetically that she is not spoiled. So what happens now? Well, realistically, the only way I can imagine Veruca being good is if she had a different reaction to the way that her parents raised her. Because Veruca's parents, in my opinion, are fairly obviously in a loveless marriage that probably only happened because of the money. I mean, just look at that age gap. I mean, it's not always true, but in this case, I think that's the message Tim Burton was trying to convey. So for this reason, I think we can already accurately say that maybe her parents didn't raise Veruca in the best of ways. Parents that don't love each other and a mother that already seems like she doesn't want anything to do with this family seems pretty rough to me. And then there's the fact that Mr. Salt is always trying to use his money to make his daughter happy. So I think we could possibly see a story going on here now. So basically, Veruca is raised by two parents that don't love each other at all, and who don't really try to understand who she is as a person. Their response to anything going wrong with her is to just shove money in her face and tell her to leave them alone. So Veruca is actually a good person that, more than anything else, just wants to be parented and wants to be understood. So when the golden ticket contest begins, Veruca wants to go to the factory still, but not because, you know, why the hell not, and she's spoiled, but because she thinks that going somewhere like that, that her father can't control the circumstances of, might help the two of them to properly bond with each other. So maybe she would then lean into a false spoiled persona to get her father to take it seriously and find her that golden ticket. And she's not cruel about it or anything necessarily, but she is desperate because she sees the ticket as her only way of finally getting through to her dad. So, of course, he still finds her the golden ticket, and they still go to the factory together. Now, when she gets there, she hopes to get her father's attention, but he's just too focused on everything else, and so she's kind of left out in the cold, and she's a little bit depressed about it. Veruca, it should also be noted, is already a bit of a lonely child, because, in my opinion, she seems like the kind of person that would have false friends. I'm not saying that that's always true, but I do think that that would help to kind of explain her isolation a little bit, because all of her friends are only hanging out with her because of her money, so they're all artificial friends. So now, at the factory, she's trying to make friends with the fellow ticket winners, because she wants somebody that wants to be friends with her for something that isn't her money. And Charlie's the only person that doesn't react to her rudely, and so the pair form an unlikely friendship with each other. But her father, of course, would be strict on her about it, telling her that Charlie isn't someone that he thinks that she should associate herself with. And Veruca gets kind of mad about that, and she says that Charlie's been nothing but nice, and he's the only person that she's met that doesn't care about her money. And Mr. Salt just says that, well, if Charlie doesn't care about your money, then he's the biggest liar that I've ever heard of. He won't have her befriending a future gold digger. And Veruca in this moment realizes that her father truly does only care about the family image, and he doesn't really care about her. So Charlie is able to help her get through this during their time together at the factory, and their friendship only becomes stronger as a result. Ultimately, a non-spoiled Veruca would, of course, not try to steal a squirrel and doesn't fall into the incinerator. She and her father continue on to the TV room where Mike TV still gets eliminated the way that he did. After this, Willy Wonka continues to take Charlie and Veruca to various other rooms around the factory until the day is over. And Veruca is never eliminated because, well, she's a good kid, and she ignores her father's pleas to distance herself from Charlie or try to sabotage his chances of winning. So, yeah, she stays true through, and she doesn't get eliminated. So Wonka, in the end, is kind of forced to throw his hands up and just call them both winners. He tells them that he was looking for an heir to his factory, and he wanted to find a child that was truly a good person deep down. Someone that he could trust to run his factory. And he says that both Veruca and Charlie have more than proven to him that they deserve to succeed him as co-owners. However, that's when he drops the bomb that they have to leave their families behind to do that. And now you might be surprised to hear this, but both of them give an adamant no. Because, well, I mean, of course Charlie is so close to his family, so you might be wondering why Veruca would say no, because obviously she should probably give up on her family by this point, but she's not ready to give up on her family, because despite them regularly letting her down, she's not ready to just leave and give them up forever, so she politely declines the offer, and she decides to stay in Buckinghamshire with her family, because yeah, I don't think that Veruca would want to give up on them. I think that she would want to keep trying. I don't think this would be the end of that. And honestly, I think it's kind of hard to imagine any kid actually agreeing to give up their entire family for the factory. I just think it's unrealistic. Later on, however, she does receive a letter from Charlie explaining that he managed to convince Wonka to change the rules so that she can keep her family and run the factory. He says that they won together and they should run it together. Now, Veruca, of course, is ecstatic about that, and she tries telling her father, who then forbids her to accept. He says that he doesn't want her to be associated with a poor boy and a psycho, because he did think that Willy Wonka was crazy. He says that they have their image to think about. He says that they don't need the factory. They have plenty of money already. And in the end, I think that this would be the moment where Veruca finally realizes that her parents are never going to try and understand her. It's over. They're not going to be asking how she's doing in school. They're not going to ask if she's making friends. And they're just not interested in how she's doing as a person. To them, she's just a statistic to make them look better. Now, Veruca, of course, is devastated by that, but finally has to admit that maybe Buckinghamshire just isn't the right place for her, and she defiantly decides to go to the factory. I mean, maybe she waits until she's an adult to do it, but it's in this moment that she finally realizes that her future, you know, she's on a different path than her family wants her to be on, and nothing's going to change that. So whether she goes as a kid or she waits till she's an adult to do it, she does eventually go. And she and Charlie decide to run the factory together for the rest of their lives as friends, or possibly lovers. I said in my Violet video I could imagine that extended period of time, just the two of them, with Wonka and the Oompa Loompas, of course. But like with those two together so often, I could imagine them becoming lovers. But either way, so that's what I think would happen if Veruca was not spoiled. Overall, much better timeline for her, because yeah, she was born to privilege, but you know, with privilege comes a sense of snottiness, you know, not always saying that's the case, but in this case it definitely was. But as I said, it's not always the case. I've known rich people who are not mean, so I always, you know, I like the idea that, like, you know, that she was raised wrong, and she was raised wrong. And I could imagine an alternate timeline where her being raised wrong would lead to a timeline like this, where she becomes desperate to just be parented, because some parents are just so hands-off with their kids that their kids, what they really want desperately is to just be told what to do, you know, because deep down, I think that's what every kid wants. And her parents weren't doing that. Her parents, I should say, were just pillows. They were just, you know, they were so soft with her. They were not doing anything to really parent her. They were just throwing money at her and being like, oh yeah, you want that? You got it. And I honestly just think that that would not be a good way to raise somebody. And clearly it wasn't. And even if she was still a good kid despite all that, I still think it would be a shitty way to raise a kid. So yeah, in the end, I do think this would have been a better timeline for Veruca. Now, there was a bit of a controversy with the last video. There was a fan named Gregor Craig, who I had a lengthy conversation with, I was very respectful, and he was very respectful, and he loves the book, and he thought that I was trying to change the story, because I thought the story was broken. And now I want to clarify that with the last video and with this one, I think Charlie and the Chocolate Factory is an amazing book, and I think both the movie adaptations are great. I'm not necessarily saying that this what-if scenario is like the best version. Like, I do think that the version that we have with the kids being bad is the best version. So, yeah, I just want to clarify again that this is not me saying, oh, yeah, this is the way it should have been. No, this is just me saying, like, yeah, this would be an interesting idea, like, if they had not all been bad. Because I do admit, I think it's a little bit unrealistic that only one of those five kids was good. Like, I do think realistically, usually at least two of them probably would have been good. Now, I do think Violet would have been the more realistic of them to be good, but Veruca is a close second. I said in the last video I couldn't imagine making Veruca good, but then I sat down, I thought about it, and I realized, you know what, I could do it. And then thankfully that last video got so much support, and I decided, you know, I want to put this vision out there. So anyway, guys, I hope you did enjoy what I had to say. This one goes out to Gregor Craig. I hope you enjoyed this video. He personally asked if I could do this, and I was very happy to do so. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Share with all of your friends on all your various social media platforms. Make sure to give me more what-if recommendations in the comments down below, and I will see all you guys in the next video.